want to take all of the wonderful ideas, all of the positive techniques we've discussed, and focus our attention now on applying them to something I know we can all agree on, global peace. Essentially, what I'd like you to think about is the possibility that it's really true what Jonathan Schell said in his book, The Fate of the Earth. He said, there is no solution to the nuclear dilemma. No solution other than to reinvent the world. That was the phrase he used, to reinvent the world, a peaceful world. People use this word peace in many ways. Peace is a kind of bucket-shaped word. It carries a lot of meanings and connotations, and you fill it more full of meaning as life provides a range of experiences. Peace is not very precisely defined. I think there are two main meanings in which people are using it these days, and I want to distinguish those. One is real peace. Real peace in the sense of allowing the unconscious programming to change, to develop in such a way that we have and experience inner peace. We experience real peace in our relationships with one another. Let's extend that to real peace with the planet. And our relationship to the life processes on the planet. That's a sense in which peace is an evolutionary goal. We'll get there. We have to get there. But I want right now to talk about a different, more near-term peace. In a sense, a more practical goal. I'll call it practical peace. I want to suggest why that kind of peace is much more feasible than we have thought it was. And what we need to do about it. Becoming worse and worse year after year. And when we have Star Wars, we may think temporarily that we're going to be more secure, but the more deeply we pursue that, the more we're simply seeing that there's going to be more technology in the sky, more missiles, and more insecurity. We sense that, and we know that something has to change. But besides that, we've got an assortment of new tools. New ways of looking at things that can be of assistance in this. For one thing, we have grown out of, by and large, the religious and racial issues that were the cause of many wars in the past. A lot of the wars in the past were religious wars. Much more than ever before, people recognize that reality is too rich to be incorporated in any conceptual framework, any sort of ideology. We really don't believe our ideologies anymore. We believe our experience more. And that's something that's been happening during the last quarter of a century. So we've made a lot of progress with regard to racial issues and religious issues. They're not gone yet. There's still conflict around them. But if you look at the long sweep of history, we've made a lot of progress. Secondly, there has been a slow delegitimating of war. Wars of naked aggression are really not legitimate in the way that they were even a couple of generations ago. Everybody has to label their preparation for war defense. That was not true before World War II. We in the United States relabeled our Department of War the Department of Defense because there was a felt illegitimacy to having a Department of War. So there's progress along these lines. You can't just go out and stamp out somebody else the way you could do quite legitimately, say, a century ago.
Thank you. Today we live in an environment where we are deprived of oxygen because of the air we breathe, the food we eat, and the water that we drink. And because of that, we have set ourselves up to be victims. And it's quite obvious what's going on in our world today. Well, when we look at essential oils, they have the same role and play the same function in the plant as the blood does in the human body. The essential oil is the blood of the plant. How many of you have cut your finger? And what happens? You bleed. Why do you bleed? Exactly, to cleanse and to kill the bacteria, because you have to do that to start the regeneration process of the tissue. Okay, how many of you ladies have seen a leaf on one of your houseplants torn or damaged? And what comes out? It's a liquid, isn't it? It's called the resin by some. Some call it the blood of the plant. Some call it the life force of the plant, but it's the same thing. It bleeds. It bleeds to cleanse that part where the plant is damaged, to kill the bacteria. You see, the essential oil is like the blood. It's a transporter. And the primary ingredient inside that oil is called oxygen. It has been discovered and determined now through research and the translation of papyrus and hieroglyphics in Egypt that oils were the first medicine of man. Even before herbs were used, oils were extracted from the plant and used before the actual plant was used. And as of 3 years ago, it was documented that essential oils produce the highest level of oxygenating molecules of any substance known to man. So when we think about that we can get actual oxygen from the oil, it's quite exciting. Now, not only can we get oxygen from the oil, but we also get negative ions, and we get ozone. Are they important to us? Why? Can bacteria live in ozone? Can bacteria live in a negative ion environment? No. You know, it's interesting when you look at what's going on in our world, because there's a big wave that has hit the United States called antioxidants, right? And everybody's looking for antioxidants and antimicrobial substance to take. We're just going to walk through some things real quickly and show you why essential oils are the missing link in our health field today, and why everyone and every home needs to have them.
I love you. I'm sorry for what happened. I know you loved me. You did your best. Sorrow today, that there's nothing you can do to bring your partner back.
What happened?
Remember the simple things that your partner used to do. Things like planning, organizing.
I know you love me.
Cooking, driving, carrying a box, paying a bill. Feel how much you miss them.
I know you love
me.
You did your best.
Feel your warm affection for your partner.
And your appreciation for their caring. It feels so good to care about another.
Hello.
It feels so good to care about another.
It feels so good to care about another.
Be comforted by the memories. As you feel your pain, focus on the love. That they are not forgotten. The love. Of your tender love. Rooted by the memories. Your tender love. Let them know. Feel your partner's love envelop you and surround you. In your heart, let them know right now. Shopping. Feel the pain of your loss. Feel your gratitude for your partner's support. Feel your need for caring. Imagine that you're back in time to be part of a loving relationship. Continue to focus on your gratitude for your partner's love. Be full with an abundance of love and support. The simple things. Remember the simple things that your partner used to do. Things like planning, organizing. Feel your warm affection for your partner and your passion. Feel your special love as you feel the pain of being alone today or about another. Feel your special love as you feel the pain of feel your special love as you feel the pain. Feel your special love as you feel the pain. Feel your special love as you feel the pain of. I know you love me. You did your best. Let your soul be comforted by the memories of love.
You
did your best. Know that one day, soon, your pain will go.